A warm welcome to you all children. We have completed tsunami lesson. Have you read the full lesson, the tsunami? Part 1, part 2 and part 3 is over. Have you all read the full lesson? Hope so, you would have read the full lesson. If you have not read the lesson, do read children and try to understand what is given over there. It is better to do one thing. When you read the story, try to have the slides video which is being given for you there. Have a parallel understanding of the story and the video link. That will help you to do the work. Now, in today's session, what we are going to do is, we are going to discuss the book bag exercises. This time, I am going to give you the ideas of how the question can be answered. So this is the first session I am doing that. Why I am doing so is, I could feel like some of you are struggling a lot to get answer for the questions. So particularly in today's session alone, I will give you the ideas how to write the answer. Because here tsunami lesson has some question which you have to think and answer on your own. That is the reason why I am going to discuss with you the question answers. Read out the question first. Come on, read the question with me. When he felt the earthquake, do you think Ignatius immediately worried about the tsunami? Give reason for your answers. Just turn the textbook, children. This is the book bag exercise of lesson 2. Question number 1, working with the text. You can find this question in working with the text. When he felt the earthquake, do you think Ignatius immediately worried about the tsunami? Give reason for your answer. How will you answer this question? Do you think Ignatius immediately worried about the tsunami? You have read the lesson, no? Yes, he worried about tsunami. And what is the reason you will give to justify the sentence? The reason you are going to give is, no, Ignatius did not think about the tsunami. He felt that there will be tremor, but he never realized that it will be tsunami. Here, how we are going to answer the question now? No, Ignatius did not think about the tsunami. He could feel like it was earthquake, but he doesn't have any idea that it will be tsunami. He thought that it was just an earthquake, so he took the television off the table. What is the meaning of the word off the table? From the table and put it on the ground. His family did not have time to discuss and plan their course of action. That is the reason why you could see like the entire family will be taken by the wave. They don't have any idea that it will be tsunami. They felt like it was just an earthquake. Again, I read the answer for you. No, Ignatius did not think about the tsunami. He thought that it was just an earthquake. So he took the television off the table and put it on the ground. His family did not have time to discuss and plan their course of action. Is it clear for you, children? The answer is clear for you? The answer is clear for you now. You can take down this point to justify your answer. When we move to the next question, what is the next question? Which sentence in the text tells you that the Ignatius family did not have any time to discuss and plan their course of action after the tsunami struck? In the first answer, we have discussed like they don't have time to discuss and they don't have time to plan their course of action, what they are going to do. Because this happened early in the morning at 6 a.m. They don't have time to think what it will be and how it will be. How you are going to answer this question? The following sentence tells that you are going to identify this sentence from your textbook. The following sentence tells about the chaos and confusion. Chaos. They are disturbed. They have many thought processes in their mind. What are the lines? Two of his children caught hold of the hands of their mothers and fathers and mother's brother and rushed in the opposite direction. This line you could see there in the textbook. This shows that they don't have a plan of what they are going to do, how they are going to move. Is it clear for everyone? So this is the way you have to write your answer. The second answer is clear for you. I'll pause here for a while to get the answer. You can even locate this answer in your textbook and write it down in your classwork notebook. Are you writing down in your classwork notebook? Again, the answers will not be given, children. This is the time you have to write the answers. Next question. Which words in the list below describe Sanjeev in your own opinion? There will be a character called Sanjeev and he is a policeman. And there are some words over here. Cheerful, heroic, ambitious, selfless, brash, heartless, brave, careless, humorous. Now I want my children to write down the meaning of the words first. Do you all have your dictionary with you? Take your dictionary and get the meaning of these words. Come on, get the meaning of all these words. Cheerful, heroic, ambitious, selfless, brash, heartless, brave, careless and humorous. Now, how will you describe the character of Sanjeev? The character of Sanjeev can be described as brave, heroic and selfless. Have you got the answer, children? So this is the way you have to write answer for the questions. Next, use words from the list to complete three statements below. I don't know if Sanjeev was cheerful. And we have already seen a list of words over here. What you are going to do is, I'll give you time. Find the meaning of these words in the dictionary and you are going to fill up the blanks now. Have you got the meaning of all those words? I always want my children to have a dictionary in hand. Are you doing the same? Do you have a dictionary for you? If you don't have a dictionary, ask your parents for a dictionary. Find out the meaning. Fill the gaps. I read the question for you. I don't know if Sanjeev was cheerful, dash or dash. I don't think that he was brave, dash and dash. Sanjeev was not heartless, dash and dash. These answers are something it is going to get related over here. We have already discussed brave, heroic and selfless. So these answers are something related to that. Will you fill the column? Have you all filled the column? Now shall I give you the answers? First, Sanjeev, I don't know if Sanjeev was cheerful, ambitious or brash. Second, I don't think that he was brave, heroic and selfless. Third question, Sanjeev was not heartless, he was careless or humorous. He was not careless, he was not humorous. So what are the answers, children? Ambitious, brash, heroic, selfless, careless and humorous. Have you filled the column with answers then? I'll give you time over here. You can just fill the answers. Fill the answers in the book now. Shall we move on to the next question? Okay. Question number 3. How are Meghna and Alma's stories similar? How are Meghna and Alma's stories similar? Here you could see, how are Alma's and Meghna's stories similar? Meghna and Alma's both were lucky. How? They both were saved. Meghna was carried away with her parents and other people, but she alone survived. You could see this character, Meghna alone could survive. She was washed ashore by a wave. Almas climbed onto a log of wood. When she opened her eyes, she found herself in a hospital. You are going to write the answer. Yes, Meghna and Alma's stories are similar because they are the one who survived for their life. Even though they were carried away, but they found something for survival. Almas got a log of wood. She climbed and she found herself in a hospital. In this way, the story of Meghna and Almas are similar. I'll give you time to write down the answer, children. Take down the answer. Shall I read it for you again? Meghna and Almas both were lucky. Meghna was carried away with her parents and other people, but she alone survived. She was washed ashore by a wave. Almas climbed onto a log of wood. When she opened her eyes, she found herself in a hospital. You can just pause the slide, you can write down the answer. Or if you need only ideas, you can continue with your own answer. Next slide. What are the different ways in which Tilly's parents could have reacted to her behavior? This is from part 2 when we see the character of Tilly. What are the different ways in which Tilly's parents could have reacted to her behavior? What would have done if you were in their place? You have to think on your own, then you have to write the answer. What will be the answer then? The answer is, Tilly foresaw the danger of tsunami at once. She became hysterical. What is the meaning of the word hysterical? Sorry, I missed a C over here. You can write the word hysterical. See, her parents did not ignore her. When Tilly told them that it is tsunami waves, her parents did not ignore her. They were sure that something wrong must be going to happen. So, they all left the beach and they were saved. If I were in a place of Tilly's parents, I might not have believed her. If I were in a place of Tilly's parents, I might not have believed her. So, when the session is going to end, you are going to give me the meaning of the word hysterical. Have you taken down the answer, children? Next question. We are going to go into the next question now. If Tilly's award was to be shared, why do you think that she could share it with her parents or her geography teacher? What will be the answer? If Tilly's award was to be shared, who do you think she should share it with? With her parents or her geography teacher? To whom should she share the award? To her parents or to the geography teacher? I'll give you time to think over the answer here. Either she should share the award with her parents or to the geography teacher. Have you read part 2? What is the role of geography teacher over there? And what is the role of her parents? From your opinion, this should be shared with whom then? Have you got an idea? Keep on thinking, children. If you have not read part 2, turn the pages and you can start reading part 2. There you will get a clear understanding. Like either she should share the